Hello, everybody. My name is April Nicole, and I am the owner, founder, and head clairvoyant at Sister Girl Readings, Sisters Tarot. And it's Mercury retrograde, so I'm be tripping over my words, but I want to make sure I get everything out. Okay, so as you guys know, I do a lot of music therapy, a lot of different forms of therapy. I also do picture therapy. Vibrational therapy, just some certain things. I use the divinational methods, and so I was tweaking my music one, and I just got the epiphany to spread the word of what I got. Maybe it will mean something to someone out there. There is someone trying to communicate via radios, and I don't know if it's a 5D thing or like a 3D thing where people are like literally like wishing and hoping, be 5D. Wishing and hoping that someone can hear you on the other side. Someone could not communicate the way they want to, so they decide to use music, or they use pictures, or they use memories or numbers. I know that because I literally was trying to do my own divination this afternoon, and I kept getting the same songs over and over again as an answer, and I said that was very weird. For it to be that accurate, I have over 2,000 songs in my iPhone. So for me to be able to pick up, that is amazing. I know that then I'm actually getting someone. I know that may seem crazy to those who don't believe in that type of stuff, but I do. With my retrograde Jupiter, I do find the meanings and things that people find frivolous. And I do actually find answers there with my Pisces North Node to lead me. So I will say, someone is trying to communicate. If you ask, I always tell my clients, if you ask a question and just wait for the music to answer you and it's the same songs, then it lets you know that it's the same energy, no matter what you do. So someone is trying to communicate what they want to say before they actually get too fucking frustrated and just say, all right, bitch, let me just go ahead and tell you what it is. Someone has a secret language. There is a secret language out there that someone is trying to get someone to learn their language. And, you know, Sagittarius is the king or queen of philosophical stuff, like languages and studying, being a forever student. So there is a Sagittarius person channeling or being channeled or trying to get a message from a source. I don't even think the source is inhuman. I think the source is alive. I think that the person who's speaking to you on the other end is another person trying to reach you or trying to reach someone. It could be your ex. It could be someone new. I don't really know who it is per se, but that's why I'm going to do the reading to find out. But there is someone trying to, I think that, I don't know why they can't communicate with you. I honestly feel like they just want to talk to you. Maybe it's because their life. Maybe someone lives a different life, and it's like that movie. You ever see that movie where the girl, she real poor and the dude rich, and they worlds don't mix? What's that movie called? Pretty, is it Pretty Big? I'm not sure, but it's a girl, she real, real pretty, but the dude is rich and shit. He try to play her off like he don't know her and shit. She like, well, fuck you, Blaine. Yeah, there could be a Blaine out there. He's a player. I wouldn't say he's a complete player, but he seems more preoccupied with people's opinions than anything else. All right, so let's see. Definitely is a man out there, Blaine, whatever the fuck is it. I think this movie, I can't, yeah, you know, I don't know, but I just get that whole Pretty in Pink vibe where the girl is broke and the nigga got a whole bunch of cash and shit. And he's afraid to be seen with her and tries to invite her into his world. And then he gets turned down and his friend's like, oh, fuck you. Fuck your friend. Like the bitch came in the room and shit. And the girl was like, aren't you in my math class? I'm like, bitch, you fucking sober, bitch. How the fuck you know I was in your math class? That bitch, like, she snort cocaine every week of her life. Talking about, are you in my English class? They be fucking with the little Pretty Pink girl. I can't think of her name. And she had a little boyfriend that liked her, and she never paid attention to him. I know he felt some type of way, but the guy made her music tapes and shit. That's what I get from this whole reading. Like, y'all should watch that fucking movie. I have that movie in my phone somewhere, but it's about a woman. I think it's Pretty in Pink. She, her mama died, and her daddy raised her, and so all she had was literally her daddy, and so he was a drunk. So she would go to school and she was just trying to make her own clothes and shit. And the little motherfuckers at school made fun of her and shit because she was different. And a lot of you motherfucking Sagittarius got Aqua moons, Gemini moons. I ain't going to include Libra because Libra wouldn't be called dead. Just Sagittarius as a sign. Don't give a fuck about really how they look unless they got some type of placement that says otherwise, like Taurus or Libra or Virgo. But honestly, I just kept getting a, or Leo too. I just kept getting a pretty in pink vibe. Like literally someone is from the other side of the tracks. They don't dress the same. They dress unorthodox. Someone could be like fashion behind. And someone drives around in BMWs and Lamborghinis and their father goes to the yacht and fucking gets drunk and gets wasted with their mother fucking around with five different niggas at once. Not shaming anybody, of course. But that's just a lifestyle they come from. And now they gonna bring this broke ass young girl with one daddy and they both got both their parents and he gotta hide the bitch and shit, like, oh, hide it in the bushes. And she like, so when you gonna come out and tell everybody about me? And he like, well, you know. And she like, nah, motherfucker, tell me when we gonna come out. And this nigga looking like, oh, and she like, okay, you know what, fuck you, fuck your money, bye bye bitch. And then the best friend get mad and shit. I'm telling the movie, y'all, but for real, y'all really need to watch that damn movie. That movie remind me of the reading that we're gonna do today. So I'm going to find out who the fuck is channeling this because it's been getting on my nerves. Hopefully they can get their message across. I'm going to call this the radio. But they're going to get their message across to whomever they're trying to talk to. Who is the one sending these messages to Sagittarius? Because it is a Sagittarius or someone is receiving, trying to get out to Sagittarius. Who is sending these fucking songs and shit? Who is this? Somebody. Somebody is getting out of jail, huh? All right, so prison was reversed. Who the fuck is sending Sagittarius? Somebody trying to escape. The military? Maybe someone's in the military. Murky thoughts is reversed in the court. Someone's trying to get out of something. Okay, so the military card is official, the proper way of doing things. And then the murky thoughts is like someone has no fucking murky thoughts. They know exactly what they want to do. So it seems like somebody want to have their cake and eat it too before they get a divorce. That's what it seemed like. Somebody want to get out, but somebody's doing something unofficial. What's the military card? Somebody going to get trouble. Okay. Sad news. These cards won't even let me finish. A long road. This shit going to be quick. A rich girl. So somebody finna get that divorce and they finna become a rich bitch. The main woman. She finna come up. That's what he think. The short illness. He think he finna be down. Like for a long time, sad news. So like somebody, lady, old lady finna come up. And the dude finna be asked out. So some woman. So somebody finna get a divorce. This is a divorce reading. So there's some man out there. He think that this bitch finna come up off of him. She probably is. And he finna be this the fucking pointed. And so he upset. So that's the wrong way of doing things. I guess that's how he didn't think it was going to work out. But it did. What's the murky thoughts? It's cool. Thievery, a good lady. The change. Yeah, he thinks that this bitch stole her money. I mean, she's been with you all them damn years. Depending on how long she's been with you, motherfucker. She didn't really take nothing. So I be some men think that they are really good men. And, oh, I was so good to her. I did this and that. And I'm just like, my nigga, no, that don't really count for everything. You got to think about the whole relationship. If y'all were together through thick and thin and you treated her like she was nothing but Bennigan's and you know she was Red Lobster or some Ruth Chris, what the fuck? Like, you better give her half your damn money. Especially if she didn't been there for you and she ain't had to and all the motherfuckers laughed at your ass and she pulled you through. A lot, like I said, a lot of dudes think that, oh, I'm a stand-up guy. No, you're not, motherfucker. Not if she taking half your shit and she leaving. Didn't did something. Somebody done went wrong. Now, I'm not going to place all the blame on Divine Masculine because we all know that women, let's be real, some of y'all chicks and women ain't always good people. When a woman gonna get mad at me like, ah, bitch. Well, I mean, hey, it is what it is, motherfucker. Get mad at shit. I'm just saying that some dude feel salty because he feel like he was a good dude and that he worked hard as shit and he took care of his bitch and then now he got to get half his money away. But we don't know the whole story. All we know is that this nigga trying to do some sneaky shit while he getting his divorce that ain't going to take that damn long that he could fucking wait for to try to holler at some other woman that ain't got nothing to do with him. And if you're doing this shit, it's going to backfire on your ass. Wait till your ass is divorced, motherfucker.
That's why you're sending motherfucking bird signals and songs and shit. You can't talk to the girl you want or really want because your wife going to find out and then include it in her divorce settlement. Yeah, she's smart. That girl is smart. She going to get you. I don't know who you are, but you need to get you a lawyer. If you ain't already got your lawyer, get two of them. Murky thoughts. Yeah, this motherfucker's clearly and unclear. He feel like this woman is stealing something, but the theory is reversed, so he has to give it to her. It's not like she just walking out the door and he's asleep. He's watching this bitch take the money. It's like if you getting repossessed, you watching the tow man take your car away. That's kind of how it is. This woman is taking half her share and she's out the door. And depending on what happened in that damn marriage, I'm kind of with her because it was a man, I'd be with him too. If you've been married for so long and these people didn't put up with your shit, I'm not saying they should get all your money. I'm thinking that they should get their share and get the fuck on so they can keep living their lives accordingly. Now, someone changed it, so it's going to be some changes. Now, let's look at the court. What is the court? And this is Kipper, by the way. The court is a success in love. Woo, man, yes, reverse. False person. Yes, somebody married someone, whole big water. Somebody married somebody, ain't nothing like they thought they was going to be. They thought this relationship was going to be perfect, and they perfectly were wrong. So, yeah, this is a motherfucker that's sending your fucking messages through the goddamn music shit. All right, so what this motherfucker want to say? Because he surely is communicating. It's split. A funeral. Sad and grief. Somebody drinks, the good Lord, a living room. Somebody drinks in their living room at night because their relationship is over with. A rich man. Somebody broke. A main male. Expectations. So someone's expecting some money. But, I mean, that's never going to change. Change is reversed. So, okay, so he done got rid of his woman. The woman took her money. He feel like, oh, she took my money. And then, okay, so she took your money, divine masculine. Okay, oh, well. Now, you're drinking grief and sorrow because you're upset because you feel like your relationship is over. The good Lord, maybe a man. You could be talking to an older brother or uncle or father in your living room. Or you could just be drinking and coming up with shit and becoming more mature. The more you take a drink, I don't advise that. But if that's what you're going to do. Somebody is in their living room. It's like this woman is grabbing this person as they leave. Please don't go. Like somebody is holding somebody, the other man. Maybe you drinking with the other man. Some of y'all are upset or drinking about a father figure in your living room. Some of y'all crying about your father. I don't know what happened to him. But this rich man, somebody don't look at themselves as a wealthy man. Somebody don't look at them. Somebody's expecting some money though. But again, the change is reversed. I don't know what that is. Let me see. What's the change reverse? Somebody saying it's not going to be for the better. The good lady, a long road. So some going to be over. A pleasant letter. Yeah, they going to get a divorce, motherfucker. A journey. Somebody don't want to go nowhere. Thievery. Somebody want to take your money and still be in your life and harass you. I don't know if y'all have any kids together, but this bitch ain't going nowhere. She clearly has made her way here, and she is not going anywhere. She said, nigga, we here, and I'm going to stay here forever. So this woman, you got some type of woman in your life that even if you pay her off, she's still going to be involved with you. Let's see more about this woman. Unexpected money, expectation, and the change. That's her ass. She about to take her money and dip. She said everything looking up from here. Why she looking so excited? Why she so happy to get the fuck up out of there? Some woman like, bye-bye. Damn, let's see. The good lady, a long road, a pleasant letter. She must have got some news about this man. Somebody got some news about a man coming up or something. What's up with this long road and pleasant letter reverse? What's that? You got some news, something to get some money, success and love. Okay. So she found out some niggas from the... Yeah. She found out that some nigga got a job. He got some type of job with taking shit from people. Somebody's a con artist. So maybe she took his money to keep him quiet. Somebody's a con artist. I don't know if it's the woman or the man, but somebody is robbing somebody. I don't know. Somebody's occupation is stealing shit. Oh no, but maybe she bribed him and now she could have found out he had another bitch and then that's why she bribing him. Oh, it looked deceitful as hell. Let's switch to tarot. Oh gosh. Well, hold on. I want to say something real quick. Let me ask this oracle deck. It's called the Divine Energy Oracle Deck. Hold on. I want to know what the fuck is up with this guy using music or other means to channel. What the fuck? Okay, speak up. So this motherfucker's not saying anything. Reverse. Correct your mistakes. Somebody is not saying something about what the fuck they did wrong. Or someone is not... Someone will not own up to whatever they've done. What is correct your mistakes? What in the fuck? Yo, that speak up card. We're on the floor. Make no judgments. Yeah, somebody lied. There's some type of lie. Speak up is now up here. Okay, so now somebody really wants to speak after they've been fucking hit to the rock bottom. Somebody wants to correct their mistakes and make no judgments is here. So someone is trying to not be so judgmental. Maybe someone's trying to correct their wrongs. It just seems like a bunch of bullshit. So somebody got their ass whooped in life and now they're trying to come back and fix things. I mean, I don't know why this motherfucker wants to speak to you, but of course, according to this, and that it comes with a little book I'm trying to get this together, but according to this, it seems like somebody didn't want to talk to you. They didn't want to speak up. They didn't want to correct anything. They didn't, it's like someone just didn't want to do anything. You know what I'm saying? And it's like now they're in a position where they have to, or maybe they feel obligated to. Maybe someone is struggling with someone they don't fuck with. Someone could be annoyed by someone's behavior. And someone is just like not very, they're lower vibrational. Yeah, somebody's really judgmental. They have like a high, they look at you with their nose in the air. Someone is very, like they know, someone wants to change the fact that they're fucking like, they're snooty. Someone's a fucking snooty bitch. And I don't know who the fuck this is. Who is the snooty motherfucker? I want to know now. Y'all done got me all up. Hold on. I might use Kipper. Oh, no. I'm not going to use Kipper. It's too wrong. Who is snooty? Who is the make no judgment? Who are you talking about? Oh, shit. The devil. Could be a Capricorn, Cancer. This will be the Page of Pentacles, King of Pentacles. Yes, an earth sign. Could be a Capricorn, Five of Pentacles. Someone trying to get change and be something different. The Page of Wands. Yeah. Okay, so the Eight of Wands reverse. Somebody not speaking. Eight of Wands is no communication. That'd be First Deacon Sagittarius. Yeah, the Page of Pentacles is kind of like somebody that has a lot of promise. They're a younger man. Maybe younger than you, but somebody has a lot of potential. Someone's a hard worker. Maybe they don't have, maybe someone just works a job at the fundamental level, like an employee. They're not like the knight where they do finally get their own shit. Like they start to be their own man and they start to build that dream. But honestly, here it says here, this motherfucker, the devil is about releasing someone. Someone could be releasing any type of negative behavior or thoughts. The King of Pentacles, someone is offering someone a job, maybe. Maybe it's a job, the King of Pentacles, or someone is taking a job, or someone is going to school. The Five of Pentacles is like someone coming out or coming up. This could be a Taurus. The Page of Wands is like someone that's a someone argumentative. Like they have problems communicating. Like the Page of Wands could literally be like a person who's snappy. It can also be someone that don't listen to you, or someone that just, they're very distracted or bored, or they just, their communication could go left. Yeah, somebody ass is judgmental as hell. That's what it says here. Again, somebody's trying to like not be childish. Maybe they're trying to change their ways. But someone is very like, I don't know, they have like a lot of thoughts. What's the correct mistakes? Correct your mistakes. The Hierophant. This could be someone that is, maybe someone doesn't think outside the box, or someone could be traditional or non-committal. The Chariot is like someone that makes bad decisions, or the Chariot can also be like wrong directions or changes. Change of plans. Someone fell in love with somebody. The Fool reverse is Page of Cups. Fool reverse is like this relationship is rocky as fuck. Someone don't know what to do. Someone is manipulative. Maybe somebody's trying to manipulate someone to having sex with them and it didn't really work. Okay, so it seemed like somebody could have wanted to have sex with someone and be non-committal and that didn't work out for someone. Like someone likes somebody, but like the Fool is kind of like stupid shit, goofy shit. Now someone's like trying to decide what to do. Maybe someone did something negative or manipulative, or they feel like they missed an opportunity. Three of Cups can be like not being a friend with someone, or like some friend jeopardizes something, like cattiness, drama. Maybe someone is indecisive about like a friend or falling out. Maybe something didn't work out. Someone wants to correct a situation with like either a religious figure or like a friend that they fell out with. Interesting. Why was speaking up reverse? This would be Knight of Cups. Yeah, somebody is a hoe. Somebody not saying nothing. Someone's stuck in the dream world. They're not really trying to manifest anything. Somebody ass is a fucking liar to me. Like the Knight of Cups and one of my decks, it was a Romeo man that had his hand behind his back. That means he lying to you. Someone is just not a very trustworthy person, and they got problems. They step away from you when you ask them questions and shit. They're like, huh, what? Yeah, somebody not really talking about what's really going on with them. They want to be judgmental towards you, though, and tell you what the fuck you doing wrong. Yeah, make no judgments. Try to fall back down. So someone is incredibly judgmental, but that didn't answer my question. What the fuck do they want with you? Two of Wands. They don't know. They deciding. Ace of Cups. Seven of Swords. See? Now, this could be a nice thing. Queen of Wands reverse. King of Swords. Somebody wants to steal your heart, but I don't trust them because it seems like they up to no fucking good. Now, the Two of Wands can be like decisions. How do I get what I want? Like, with the Seven of Swords, do I want to fuck this person over or do I want to fall in love with them? It's literally on each side. It's Ace of Cups on one side and Seven of Swords on the other and Two of Wands. Well, what is this motherfucker going to shoot? We want to know. Four of Cups. He going to date. Okay, you going to go out, come out and do what exactly? What you going to come out and do? Two of Swords. He don't know. He don't know, motherfucker. What's Two of Swords? What you indecisive about? Judgment. Knight of Pentacles. Somebody is afraid of someone's decision. What decision are you afraid of? Or how someone's going to perceive them? Three of Wands and what is this? The Six of Wands reverse. They don't know if they're going to be able to be taken. Like the Six of Wands is checking your phone. Like someone is very in, like waiting. Someone, Page of Wands is good news. Knight of Wands is moving towards someone. Page of Wands, the world. Is somebody waiting for someone to become successful and they're waiting for the word? I don't know. It seems like somebody could be waiting on someone to come out or be seen or be public. I don't know. Like somebody could be waiting on somebody literally to be that bitch or that nigga. And then somebody want to holler at you. I don't know. I don't know how it's going to work out because get this, right? If I were to be successful, right? And I were to go and have some dude holler at me and tell me, oh, the reason why I ain't come talk to you is because I was waiting on you to be successful because I had my own bag. I'm like, oh, okay, well, I don't really know you enough to date you. So let's just not, you know, let's just be friends for about 6 or 7 years and see where it goes. Or like five, I like to put numbers on things, 5, 6 years. Now that might piss that person off. Like, damn, so I can't date you. Come on, no, motherfucker, no more, I'm married. But if I was single, no. I need to know who you are. I need time. And I don't trust nobody off the bat. It takes forever to get close to me. So it may take you 4 or 5 years till I date you. Now, that may make the average man feel like, damn, I should have said something to her before she got famous. You should have. Or rich. Or she should have. Or this dude. The woman waited forever. And then, oh, damn, I should have spoke to Divine Masculine. You should have. Now, this person wanted popping. And they don't want to talk to you. Because you acted like you ain't believe in them. And they're like, okay, that's cool. Well, I don't believe in you either, motherfucker. So you have to wait. Now you got to wait in line with all these other motherfuckers. Because you ain't hop on that dang. Now, I put all these other cards away. Because I ain't done with the other cards. Queen of Wands is still here. King of Swords. These motherfuckers are reversed. It's okay, so if they going to fuck you over, they going to fuck you over with another bitch. It's going to be a fire sign of somebody's mama. Okay, or it's going to be an air sign Capricorn. What's the Queen of Wands? Somebody don't know if they want to do something to you. They're not proud of it. Somebody wants to take your money and rob you. Ladies, any fire sign women, this woman is trying. This man going to romance you and steal your money. What's the King of Swords? Somebody wants to romance you. Five of Pentacles. He broke. He ain't got nothing. That's what he want. Seven of Pentacles, Seven of Cups. So you're going to find this out too, that someone is waiting on you, plotting on you to see if you're going to be successful. So someone doesn't know what they want to do with you. They don't know if they want to rob you or love you. I don't like that relationship because it makes me feel like someone, the fact that you would want to even decide that you want to rob somebody to get rich. And then, because you ain't got nothing, so you're going to decide, I really like this person, but I really want what I want. Do I really want to do the right thing or the wrong thing? So someone's trying to decide, they like you enough to stay around. What kind of Ace of Cups is this? Justice, Ace of Wands, King of Wands. Yeah, Ace of Wands is like, when someone gets you pregnant, they're going to leave you and act like they're not around. This could be a Libra. Somebody wants to leave you for a Libra or leave you or leave this Libra for you. But I don't get that. The Ace of Wands is like someone abandoning. It's like some type of false beginning. Like someone tells you that they love you and they never really love you. It doesn't make it feel like they really care about you. Someone is not trying to give you a commitment. They're actually trying to lead you on. They're going to have a whole bunch of other motherfuckers. If you marry this person ain't going to be your spouse. They're going to lie to you and play you. So basically, this motherfucker's trying to decide if they want to love you and then mislead you or just mislead you altogether and just say fuck the love. So basically, they fucking fuck you anyway. But they're trying to decide which way they want to do it. All right, so why is this person channeling through music? The Queen of Pentacles in the Tower. Somebody wants to ruin something. Somebody wants to ruin somebody's foundation. Ten of Cups, the Sun. Yeah, somebody wants someone to lose something. Nine of Pentacles, Two of Swords. It's because they don't know where they're going in life. The Six of Wands. It's a group of people. It's a group of people with this man. The man is leading it. It's a King of Pentacles. Could be a Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo. Could be Scorpio too. Reverse. Somebody at a distance. It's a group of people, but it's led by this man. He is trying to mislead or hurt someone. It's a woman he's trying to do it to. It's a Queen of Pentacles. Could be his kid, too. Yeah, that's probably the reason why Two of Swords and the Knight of Pentacles. He don't know how he's going to fuck over the woman because she's got the son with him. So some of y'all, this could be your own husband or baby daddy. You got his son. He's trying to find a way to fuck you over and not hurt his own son. Damn. Someone don't know what they want to really dedicate themselves to you. But I know one thing, they want to ruin your foundation, your money. Someone wants some type of paperwork involved. Someone wants to like make you miss an opportunity. Someone is sending you music to send you off. Anything else about the music that anyone could be channeling? Because I thought it was weird. Knight of Cups and the Queen of Wands. Someone wants, that's the thing though. You might leap for this, but I don't think you should. The Two of Wands and Seven of Swords. You're going to find out some shit. Someone is trying to manipulate your thoughts or manipulate you to make a move. And I don't think that you should. Okay, so what should the collective Sagittarius be doing? The Judgment card. Don't make no decisions at all. Don't make none. No decisions yet. The Emperor. Someone is a control freak, a narcissist. Someone doesn't have your best interest at heart. This earth sign person. This person is a money hungry person. This person's trying to use passion, love, and gentleness. But underneath all of that, they are the horrible Emperor verse. Ace of Cups. Someone could be getting abused by this person. Ace of Cups. Yeah, reject this. They told you to reject this. Ace of Cups is like, I'm pouring out my cup. You're going to go after something else with faith. And you know what? You may actually have hope for this person, but I feel like you would be playing yourself, Queen of Cups reverse, to emotionally give to a situation. And the Devil is at the bottom of the deck, so I know it got something to do with the Capricorn. Somebody want to work with you, but they want to steal your ideas and steal your money. Somebody's a hoe too, and they're abusive. So be careful of Capricorn. Anything else? Because I hate this so fast, Sagittarius. Anything else, Sagittarius? I knew it was something up. Seven of Wands and the Hangman. The Tower, the Sun. Okay, so someone said they're going to keep appearances. Maybe someone was going to build themselves back up, but hangman is kind of like something that turned out the way someone wanted to, and now someone kind of feels like they gotta just now kind of deal with what they got. The emperor, so the man could be feeling this way. He could be feeling like, fuck. Like, someone's going to try to avoid this plan now that it's out. They're going to try to revise another plan. What should Queen of Wands do? It seems like they're after you. The King of Swords. The Five of Pentacles. Leave this motherfucker in the street. If this motherfucker is homeless, leave their ass there. Don't feel bad for this motherfucker. They're trying to get you on the street. The Emperor, bro. He's trying to control your home. The Moon. Someone going to try to pretend they love you. And you just be not interested. Temperance. Yeah, Sagittarius. Just, eh, I'm good. I don't want your money. It's something shady going on. Yeah, they're trying to create something shady. So, no Aries. No Virgo. No Gemini. No Aquarius. Definitely not Capricorn. And definitely not Moon and Cancer. Mm-mm. Any Earth sign woman and any Pisces. No, just reject these people. Reject anyone that is not already. It's Mercury fucking retrograde. You're supposed to be fucking nobody anyway. So you good. Hierophant. Keep with God. High priest at the bottom of the deck. Keep praying. Yeah. If you got a Taurus, stick with that motherfucker. Yeah. Somebody is on some other shit. All right. So stick with God, y'all. And so your spirit, your ancestors. And really, really use your intuition. Because people are really trying the most to try to win you over just to fuck you over. All right, I will talk to y'all later. Bye.